This is a video on how to use the Google Sheets spreadsheet program, Statistics by Larry Green, to perform some hypothesis tests and confidence intervals for 1 and 2 population means and proportions when we're given statistics instead of data. So the first thing, if you haven't already done it, you need to go to what it says data lists on this bottom tab. That means we don't have data, we have statistics instead. And when you click on that, you get the screen. And then I'll just show you the four different types of tests and confidence intervals you can do. The first one here that says 1 var CI p value, that's a confidence interval and a hypothesis test for one population mean. When you have that, the first thing you have to do is put in your x bar, which is a sample mean. So let's suppose the sample mean was 6.3. You have to put in s, which is a sample standard deviation. And in this case, s is equal to, say, 2.1. If you click this little arrow, you could call it sigma instead of s. And if you know sigma, the population standard deviation, that means that you use a z test instead of a t test. So normal distribution instead of the t distribution. Typically, you're going to be using the t distribution. And then n is our sample size. So let's suppose we had 42 different data values. Mu naught is going to be the null hypothesis test number. So that would mean h naught means that the mean is equal to whatever this mu naught is. And let's suppose that mu naught was 5, for example. And then we have H1, mu question mark, mu naught. So we have a choice between a left tail, a right tail, and a two-tail test. If I hit this little arrow here, then let's suppose we had a two-tail test. So H1 was that mu is not equal to 5. The confidence level, we could change that from 95% to say 90% if we want, or keep it at 95%. So after entering in all these values, we get our confidence interval, and we also get our p-value and test statistic for the hypothesis test. So notice we can be 95% confident that the population mean is between about 5.65 and 6.95. The test statistic for this particular hypothesis test is that t, in this case, because we have s, is equal to about 4.01. And the p-value is 0.0002. Very strong evidence to support the hypothesis that the population mean is not equal to 5. Okay, so the next one I want to look at is 1 prop CI p-value. This is a hypothesis test and a confidence interval for a single population proportion. Very similar. In this case, you have x, which is the number of yeses. So let's suppose we had 230 of them. We have n is the number of people who were surveyed, which is, let's suppose we had 770. We have p naught, and that is in the hypothesis test. The null hypothesis is that the population proportion is equal to p naught. So let's suppose that our p naught was, I don't know, 0.4. And we have to choose between greater than, less than, or not equal to. Let's go for less than this time. Confidence level, I'll leave it at 0.95. You could change it if you want. And there we have it. P hat is the sample proportion, which in this case was 0.29. We could be 95% confident that the population proportion is between about 20.27 and 0.33. Here's our z statistic. Our test statistic is z equals negative 5.7 about. And our p-value is really, really tiny. Okay, the next one I want to look at is 2-var CI p-value. So that is a confidence interval for the difference between two population means. So I'm not going to go through changing all the numbers, but x bar 1 is the sample mean for the first sample. S1, and you can change that to sigma if you have the population standard deviation, is the standard deviation of the first sample or population. N1 is the sample size for the first sample. X2 bar is for the second. S2 is for the second, and N2 is for the second. And similarly, you can choose your H1 alternative hypothesis to be two-tailed, left-tailed, or right-tailed. We could choose our confidence level to be something other than 0.95, and then the computer gives us the difference between the sample means. It gives us a confidence interval, lower bound and upper bound. It gives us our T or Z statistic, the p-value, and in this case also the degrees of freedom. So similarly, the fourth one is 2 prop CI p-value. That is to conduct a hypothesis test or a confidence interval for the difference between two proportions. And here again, I'm not going to go through all of them, but we have the number of yeses for the first sample. We have the sample size for the first sample. We have the number of yeses for the second sample, the sample size for the second sample. We put all those numbers in. We have H1. In this case, it's P1 is either going to be not equal to, less than or greater than. And we have the confidence level. And then the computer will give you the p hat 1, which is the sample proportion for the first sample, p hat 2, which is the sample proportion for the second, p hat 1 minus p hat 2, that just subtracts those numbers. We have our lower bound and upper bound for the confidence interval. We have our test statistic, z, and we have the p value for this hypothesis test. So that's about it for this tab. If you have any questions, drop me an email at drlarrygreen@gmail.com. That's drlarrygreen@gmail.com. Thank you for watching this video.